told us to pray. So we prayed. But sincerely, if prayers were to be stored in Africa, if prayers were to be stored in a room, ours in Africa will beg for space. For more space. For even more space. I mean, we say we are a people supposedly united with one voice, one dream, one goal, one vision. But instead, I see us as white light, a spectrum. Because we are obviously a race of different colors striking a screen. We definitely can't eat the same spot. I mean, our wavelengths and frequencies aren't equal. We just can't share the same properties. But still, we combine ourselves under the facade of love, of international interest. We say we seek to promote unity. But in the end, we follow the same process as hydrochloric acid poured into water. We explode. We bear grudges against one another. We say we fear. We fear of the unknown, of the unknown fear eating us from behind. We become scared of fear itself. So a part of us begins to attack, while a part of us also flee. Like dust in a light wave, we scatter in fulfillment of the prism law. Now we no longer see ourselves as one but 54. We draw swords against each person, promoting death and death and death until the end comes. Then we begin the process all over again. Gradually we become a gun without a trigger. Then the recoil disappears too. To our faces we will crumble. We will see our remains and fear. But tears. Tears won't drop. I mean, there are some situations more burdensome for tears to flow. So instead, we keep praying intensely until we lose every of our voices like God turned deaf over the decades. We would run, yell, scream, run helter-skelter over the doom we brought upon ourselves. Until then, would we understand the true meaning of love, of peace, of togetherness and harmony. Until then, would we understand that every part of this body will keep remaining as white light only when we begin to overturn the prism that scattered us in the first place. Until then would we understand that Africa will keep remaining one only when we ourselves begin to take intentional actions towards making it one. We will understand that every one of us is a soldier, and to uplift this troop, we need to be united.
I know of a color station, a village where rainbow marks the junctions. A dungeon of gold and robbers, riches in minerals, diamonds in the sizes of tubers, and of people with heart of angels, living as gods, wearing cultural singlets. They polluted their eyelashes with confusion and subsequently many civilizations. A toast with the visitors from the sea must be what led their forefathers at sea. So they offered their culture to vultures. They fell in greed and tricks of colors. Every one of them wanted to be white before believing they are doing what is right. So they began to trade their common senses. The beauty in their valor chose to live in past tenses. They made their land with scars of borders. They derived dignity in butchering their brothers. Yam, pepper, scatter, scatter. Yam, pepper, scatter, scatter. Their children lost their leaders. Their kings served ugly, strange monsters. So, no valleys left of their mothers. That's how it is in my motherland. That's how we roll in Africa land. We desert our home and travel abroad. We desert our gold and trading stones. If Ghana carries where Cameroon Campbell draw, if Tanzania tarries where Tunisia Campbell stop, maybe birds in Naija would then begin to fly as birds. Maybe rats in Libya would then crawl as rodents. Our unity freed Mandela. Africa! How? Our diversity sold Gaddafi in his own arena. Africa! How? He that cherishes only what not belong to him runs away from peace. Such a great misfortune, knowing we have been living like this. Albert Okuti, Alaska in Africa.
Africa! Okay, so we have the scores for Emmanuel. Can we have it raised? Let's start from the, yeah. Six. Six. Seven. Seven, six. And finally six. A round of applause for Emmanuel. And next up, we're going to take the scores for Albert Okuti. Do we have it? Seven, seven, eight, nine,
finish him.
Nine,
finish him.
And eight,
fatality.
That is
finish
fatality.
Finish him.